Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And of all days, I now have a cold. I've not had a cold or been sick all winter. First day I'm going to be really planting vegetables, I get a cold. Anyway, it's beautiful out. Yesterday we planted perennials, and today we're going to start with the vegetables. And the first thing we're going to start with, although it's pretty late, is peas and beans. It was just so nasty before this. If it wasn't frost warnings, it was rainy or it was chilly and windy. So today's the first lovely day. It's in the 70s. So today's the day. In years past, when I've cleaned up in the garden, we've always taken out all the labels of everything that we have planted. And I'm beginning to think that's not such a good idea, because if you have a memory that maybe will forget if you haven't taken pictures of what you had where, this is kind of a reminder for you of what was there last time you planted. In this particular bed, we had cabbage things, the Chinese cabbages and all sorts of that family. So I don't want to grow them in this same soil because there are insects and viruses and bacterias that will go after certain plants. So if you want to have a opportunity to change things around, give this bed a year off from doing that sort of family, those things will die because they don't have a source, and thus it'll be a healthier environment for everybody. We also, in the past, have always taken everything off the beds and cleaned them up and then rototilled. This year we decided we were going to leave the leaf mulch on and all the grass clippings that we put on last summer and just make planting areas in the spaces that we were going to be planting, and thus leave all the nutrients in the ground and not expose everything to the air.
Well, the other thing too is it stabilizes the soil structure itself.
Yes. So what I'm doing today is I'm going to be digging a trench that will be just for the size of the bean area that I'm going to be planting in the peas, and I'm going to be putting compost in there. So let me just get my trench going here. I always remember my dad using a hose when he was planting beans and peas. Okay. Now, we're going to be putting peas on this side, and we're going to be using our trellis system from the Better Built people in Illinois. They were kind enough to send these to us, and so we are going to be putting them to good use. In the past, we have always built our own trellises using sticks and string, and had the peas climb up there. But then it was an everyday thing to come out and train them to go there, because otherwise they would go their own willy-nilly way. Last fall, we did a video saying what our plans for this upcoming year would be. And one of them was to do vertical gardening. And because of that, the Better Built people in Illinois saw it and decided that we would be a great testing system for their new trellis system. It's an interlocking trellis system that you can put up in a multitude of ways. We are going to use four of them for the peas this year, and we're going to use some of the other many that they sent us for other vegetables in the other garden. Instead of having to do our little stick and string, the peas will be able to climb up here very nicely because the spacing is so nice between these. They also have spacing between some of them that are larger so that you could do zucchini and squash. All right, so I have my trellis in place here. I've got my trough dug. I'm going to be sprinkling in some aged compost. Just put that in the ground. I'm going to be mixing some of the soil that was in the garden back in there. So that it can use all those nutrients from the old straw, the leaves, the grass clippings, everything we put on last summer. Early this spring, we went to the Chicago Flower Show and met the people from the seed keepers. They developed a system where you can put your seeds and save them, put them in a cool place over the winter, and then they're organized by alphabet. So all I have to do is look under P for peas. And for this first batch of planting, I'm going to be planting these dwarf white snow peas. Super sweet. Okay. Peas are very easy to grow. All right, I'm going to put some of the soil back in to my trough. Give it a little mix. And then I'm going to sow them. It says plant
with a needle and thread.
Plant 1 inch deep, 1.5 inches apart. Well, I like to do a little bit more than that. Yes, some jumped out of my hand. Now I'm only doing half a row right now because 2 weeks from now I'm going to put the other half in so that they're spaced out a little bit longer and the season lasts a little longer. All right, now I'm just pushing them in. Hopefully not getting any maple seeds in there. I don't need maple trees. We have many. Okay, and then I'm going to put some of this other soil right on top of it so that they're covered about an inch. And I know where my row ends because I'm right at the end of the trellis. As these come up, I will be putting grass clippings around them so that the soil stays moist. It'll be my mulching system. I'm using the same system I used for the peas. I've dug a trench. I've filled it with compost. I'm going to be mixing some of the soil in there. And peas are about the same size, well, I shouldn't say that. Peas are the same planting as beans. Even though beans are a little longer than peas, they are the same height as peas. So let me just put some of the soil back.
You mean the seed itself or the plant?
The seed itself is longer, but the same height. You're going to put them side by side, they'd be the same height.
So in other words, planting them in the same depth.
So these are contender buff Valentine beans. Now I thought that meant they were going to be yellow beans, but they're not. They're green, and it says they will get 5 to 7 inches thick, green, very tender, and free of fiber pods. So that sounded good to me. They're very easy to see. Okay, first I'm putting them about an inch apart, and then I'm going to add maybe another one in a different line. Again, I'm only going to do half the bed now and half in about 2 weeks. Okay, and I'll just cover them up, push them down a little bit. But here's my halfway point. It'll be easy to see where they are because they will be up by then. And now comes the fun part, the watering part. Be sure if your hose has been sitting in the sun that you let it run a little bit so that you're not watering with heated water. Kill them before they even get started. Our faucet, or our sprinkling system, is from the Dram Company, located in Manitowoc, Wisconsin. They are known for their sprinkling hoses and sprinklers.
Well, lopper systems, all kinds of quality garden equipment.
Yep. Okay, now when you're watering, you have to remember, it looks as though right now that everything is wet. Oh, I'm done. but it's not. Let it sink in a little bit, and then you're going to water them again because you want the water to get down to where you put the seeds. Now, they've promised that we're going to get rain tomorrow and Monday, Memorial Day, and hopefully we do. And this will help by packing in the seeds right where you planted them, so when the rain comes, it's not just going to wash them away. They're already in a nice level condition. Hopefully all the air pockets are gone, and they'll be stable enough so when it rains, the rain will just add to the planting condition. So I'll do it one more time. Essentially, I'm doing the same thing with these Napa cabbage that I did with the beans and peas. I'm digging the hole. I'm going to be putting the compost in there, and then I will put some of the grass that we have available from cutting our grass several times already. Now, I noticed that somebody's been nibbling on the leaves already, and that's why this is a great place for these to be this summer, because we can put a row cover over here to protect them. We also have maple seeds in there. Making sure that there's no ringing at the bottom. I want to loosen those roots up so they can go into the soil. Then I'm going to make a little moat around them to catch the water. And put the label out so we remember what they are. And then add some grass. This will keep the weeds down. It'll keep the moisture in. I don't like to put it right up next to the plant because then it's like a blocking for the moisture to get down to them. The moisture has to first go through the grass and then finally to the plant. So I keep it away from the plant itself. Now, essentially, I'm going to be doing the same thing with peppers and any other plant I do except for tomatoes, which have my own little formula, but eggplant, cabbage, peppers, they're all going to be done the same way. And this is Rose Bianca eggplant. It's going to be a little oval-shaped purple and white. Hello, Toad. You love these guys in the garden. They eat all the bad stuff, all the bad critters. We were going to put kale in a different place this year, but when we started looking this spring, I hadn't yet pulled out the old kale from last fall because it went until the very hardest frost. And when we came out this spring, it was already growing. There are three different plants that decided that they wanted to grow here again. So instead of transplanting them to another bed, we're just going to plant them right here. They like the shade of this maple tree because they like it cooler. So they're going to get their wish. Last year we were too late when we went to the garden center to get any of the dinosaur kale we love. It has the skin, it looks like the skin of a dinosaur. And it's very sweet, and it gets sweeter as the weather gets colder. Like I said, up until the really hard frost. So only because of our friend Dee, one of our viewers, she saw it, she knew we wanted it, she bought us a plant last year. She got the last one and ours. So this year we went early and we were able to get dinosaur kale for her.
Yeah, but we still got the last of what they had,
we
made it just at a perfect time.
Hopefully they got more in.
Yeah.
We were able to tell our gardening club that was one of the things that we really enjoyed, and we were glad to see that they included that in their sale.
I notice you also have some Red Russian.
Yes, I have Red Russian and White Russian. Another one that's very good too is Scarlet. But I haven't seen any Scarlet this year. Last kale going in. We were going to put it over here, but I noticed that one of the roots from last year has already sprouted, so we'll just make them cozy, put them closer together.
Notice a lot of the plants have two.
Yes. It's almost like they planted two in each pot.
Yeah.
And then didn't feel like thinning them out. Just fine. Fine with us.
Another one with two. In fact, I think only three of them came singular.
Now, some people about the middle of summer think, well, shouldn't I be fertilizing with something? Thing with organic gardening is you don't want to use synthetic fertilizer. That means it's made with chemicals. You want to use something that's organic. It comes from an organic source, like cows and chickens and goats and horses. So you can add manure tea, which you can make yourself just by getting a bag of manure, putting it in a pantyhose leg, suspending it in some water, and then after a few days you use that tea to water your plants. You can also use organic fertilizer that is very specially marked in the store. Keep your eye open for that. And you can always use worm castings and worm casting tea. Same principle as the manure tea.
Well, I suppose it's like any food you buy in the grocery store. It helps to look at the label because that's what's going in your body.
Exactly. So do you want to have synthetic chemicals in your body, or would you rather have something organic? It's up to you. So I will be putting grass around these, and they're happy in the shade, so we're just going to leave them right where they are. I'm in the process of planting our peppers. Now, not green peppers, some are green. I have three of these, which are Valencia orange, and then we have one California Wonder green, and then three Better Bell green, and a hot Hungarian wax pepper for our son, our oldest son, and our soon-to-be son-in-law, who like hot. And then we have two that are called Super Banana Supreme, and they are sweet. As you can tell, we like the sweet ones. Same thing, I'm digging the hole, then I'm going to be putting the compost in the hole and putting them in. Now, I've been reading saying that you can plant peppers deep like you plant tomatoes. With a tomato, you plant about two leaves high. But in my experience, I like to put a collar around mine to prevent cutworms from just coming along and chopping off your pepper. You come out one day and the pepper plant is down on its side and there's no way that it's going to come back up again. So in the past, and it's worked very well, is I take toilet paper tubes, cut them in half, cut a slit in the side, wrap it around the bottom of the plant, overlap it, kind of snug it down into the ground because those little worms will try to get right in there.
Oh, those are cutworms?
Those are cutworms. And they cut your plant right off. And then I just take a piece of masking tape and close it up. Now, eventually the plant will get big and the cutworms will be out of season and thus die, and you won't have to worry. The stem itself will probably break open the little collar I'm putting on, as will watering and rain. They just kind of wear down.
Well, they'll just decompose.
Mm-hmm. But in the meanwhile, you're protected against those nasty cutworms. One more to go. it's just putting grass around the edges, and then we'll be done for this one. Hope you enjoyed this. Thank you so much for watching. I hope it helps you if you're a new gardener. I was going to say farmer. A new gardener. And if you're an old gardener, that you find that what you're doing is the same as we, or maybe it's different, and you'd like to tell us about the way you do it.
You mean an experienced gardener?
Mm-hmm. Yes, not old.
Oh, okay.
Experienced gardener. So give us a thumbs up if you found it informational and entertaining. We'd love to hear what you're doing and what your comments are. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, please subscribe.
Connect with us on YouTube.